بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. إن شاء الله we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to bless us with this book we are starting called سفينة النجاة. سفينة النجاة or the ship of salvation by الشيخ العالم الفاضل سالم ابن سمير الحضرمي. This great sheikh has brought together this beautiful book known as سفينة النجاة. And it talks about salat, zakat, and all the basics about and the essentials about our deen. In this beautiful book of سفينة النجاة, there is a part which is known as سفينة الصلاة. And سفينة in the Arabic language is a ship. A ship that will save you, salvation, is of the school of Imam al-Shafi'i. Insha'Allah, we'll be starting the first part of this book, insha'Allah. قال الشيخ المصنف رحمة الله عليه ونفعنا الله به وبعلمه آمين. من يرد الله, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying, من يرد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. For whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intend goodness, He gives him the understanding of deen. In a hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, this is showing us if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves somebody, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intend goodness, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to use you in the correct way to submit you to Jannah, therefore He gives you the understanding of deen. Because if you understand deen, you will fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you understand deen, you will understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will understand the Quran, what is ordering you and what it is stopping you. You will understand the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you understand the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that you will follow the footsteps so that you can be successful the way the sahabas and all those who followed the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have become successful. It starts with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Merciful and the Compassionate. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, all praise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And anything, the way we said, anything that is started in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a blessing. And also, once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses you with anything, you should start with thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the book, the Shaykh started with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All praise to Allah is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all the worlds. وَبِهِ نَسْتَعِينُ, we seek help from Him. عَلَىٰ أُمُورِ الدُّنْيَا وَالدِّينِ, in worldly affairs and the matters of deen. Anything and everything we ask for help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the doer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who does each and everything. Whether you have a job interview, run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether your child is sick, run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you have a problem with your husband or your wife, run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who solves each and every single thing. And he said, is the sign of a good believer, a good mu'min. Or if you want to know the sign whether you are a good believer, look at yourself when a difficulty faces you. Who do you run to? Who do you ask for help? Who do you seek help from? Whether it is worldly affairs or the deen, the sahabas ridwanullah alayhim, they always understood that Allah is the one who holds the keys of everything, success, failure, every single thing, difficulties, in everything in life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who holds the keys for them. He is the one who does and He gives each and everything. Wasallallahu wasallama ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Salutation and peace on our master, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Khatamin Nabiyyin, the seal of the prophethood. He is the last prophet. He has sealed prophethoods. There is no more prophet are going to come. But now how is this deen going to go forward? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this ummah special more than other ummahs, because they were given the responsibilities of the prophets, propagating the deen and making sure that they invite people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ask people to refrain from committing sins. That is why this ummah was made special. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best of nations, and you are brought for people. تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. Enjoining goods, telling people to do good things, and reminding them of doing good things, whether they are your friends, whether they are family, whether they are Muslim brothers or sisters, whether they are your neighbors, telling them about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, if you've seen them committing sins, asking them to refrain and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With life being very short, they would not be happy to be taken, their soul to be taken while they are in that condition. Therefore, they should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خاتم النبيين وآله وصحبه. Also, the salutation also they were to be sent upon all his family, the Prophet family, and the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, who have worked so hard to make sure that deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reaches us. And also he says, وَلَا حَوْلَ. There is no power, no one has power. وَلَا قُوَّةَ. And no mighty, no one has mighty except through Allah. إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. No one has power, no one can do anything. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want it, it will never happen. No one can show their power to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah decided to destroy the whole town, no one can say anything. لا يسأل عما يفعل. No one, ولا يخاف عقباها. Allah does not fear. If he destroys something, he does not fear for people to come and attack him. You cannot do anything, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do each and everything, because each and everything belongs to him. And no one has power over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what we should believe in our heart. All the power is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the might is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nothing, no one, and nothing can happen except through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Aliyyi, the most high, Al-Azimi, and the most great. So we said, in the first part of this hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, the book starts with the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intend goodness for you, he gives you understanding of deen. So if you see somebody is attached to deen and working for deen and giving his time for deen, know that person is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know that person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is intending goodness for him. Know that person is doing the best of jobs, the job of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, in this great book of fiqh, Safina, it contains very, very important things about ibadah, about our worship. Therefore, if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your a'mals, your deeds, and to reward you greatly, you have to follow and understand, make notes, ask questions to make sure that you understand. In this very small book, inshallah, weekly we'll be sending lectures with regard to this book, part by part, slowly, inshallah. And if there's any questions, inshallah, we'd welcome brothers and sisters to ask questions, inshallah. It contains very, very important messages about our deen, on how to perform our a'mal, and what destroys our a'mal, inshallah. Inshallah, now, my dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, we'll go into explaining slightly more with regard to this part that we've studied, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all mankind, the Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of all the worlds, the jinns, the ins, everyone, all the animals, everything that is on this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, Rabbil Alameen. He is the one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all the worlds. All these things that you hear, brothers, they are batil. قُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ. all these statues, even at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are so many lords. They had gods on top of the Kaaba, almost 360 of them. So anyone and everyone who's claiming that a tree to be a lord, or a camel to be a lord, or a statue to be a lord, my brothers, is batil, completely not acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is a shirk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forgive. Inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bih wa yaghfiru ma duna thalika liman yasha. Each and everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive, but associating partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never forgives, my brothers. And the Shaykh started with Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, any action, anything that you are doing, if you have not started, or if it is not started with Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Alhamdulillah, therefore that thing is abtar, it is not blessed. So whenever we want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for dua, inshaAllah, prayer, we should say Alhamdulillah, wa thana'u lillah, wa salatu salam ala Rasulillah. We continue. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we send salutation to Allah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what we want. That dua will be blessed and acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you, grant you what you want, inshaAllah. And then, my brothers and sisters, it says, وَبِهِ نَسْتَعِينَ. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only, and to Him only, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we seek for help when we are in difficulties, in your hour of need. If you feel depressed by this world, know that this world is very short. Know that shortly you will be departing this world. Do not worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within seconds can take that difficulties and problems away. Wake up in the middle of the night, stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, present all your needs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the middle of the night, He says, where are those people who are in difficulties that I save, solve their problems? Where are those people who are in needs? I give them what they need. My brothers and sisters, whatever difficulties, whatever problems, whatever we have in each and everything of our day-to-day thing, whether it is worldly thing or the deen or akhirah, we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you've committed sin, cry to Allah and ask Him for forgiveness. If you have difficulties with your job, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has means. And also, after that, in this great book, the Shaykh is continued, saying with the salutation of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in a hadith, it is said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in hadith al-Qudsi, He said, عبدي لم تشكرني إذا لم تشكر من أجزيت النعمة على يديه على يديه. Oh my slave, you have not thanked me if you have not sent thanking and salutation to the person whom I've brought the ni'ma to you through him, through his hands, through his effort, meaning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Therefore, my brothers, when we start something, we start with thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start sending salutation to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man salla alayya fi kitabin." Whoever was to send salutation to me in any book, lam tazal al malaikatu tusalli alayhi. The angels will ask for forgiveness for you, will ask rahmah and mercy for you, ma dama ismi fi dhalika al kitab, because that book is blessed, because the name of a blessed person and beloved person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as long as it remains there, my brothers, the book will be blessed. And also it tells us that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we are sending salutation to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we must also remember his families who have given each and everything to this deen. We must also remember the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahabas, who have given their wealth, they've given their time, they've given their money. That is why today we are praying. That is why today we are Muslims. That is why, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the effort, Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. And also, it is teaching us that our Prophet is the last Prophet. There's no Prophet who are going to come. And also, no one has power over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ you cannot do anything, my brother. You cannot even worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot perform sujood. You cannot give charity. You cannot do anything without the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who's giving you the oxygen. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who's giving you the means. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who's given you the health. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who's given you everything, the movement, to go and worship Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, all the limbs, all the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, use it correctly, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power. If the eyes you are using in the wrong way, He has the power to take them away from you. If the legs, if you're using the wrong way, He has the power to take them away from you. Out of mercy, He doesn't. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put a punishment on the day of judgment for those who do not worship Him, or they use the ni'mah, the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the wrong way. Even one of the ulama, brothers, he said, if a person becomes stressed and difficulties affect him, and also when he goes and recite this dua, it is something that they have tried, and they said, if a person was to recite this adhkar and say, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyu al-azim, 300 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes all his difficulties, all his problems, because you are submitting everything, all your problems, in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you're saying that no one has power, no one has means except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are repeating that, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the power to raise that and take that away from you. Inshallah, in the next part of our book, inshallah, we will continue, my brothers, on this great book. We should follow, inshallah, so that it can be means of guidance. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.